One of the important conditions of the colon that is largely preventable is colorectal cancer, which is one of the leading causes of cancer-related death in the United States. And we know that screening for early cancers or for polyps, which could turn into cancer, can have a profound impact in decreasing death from colorectal cancer. One of the challenges we face when we think about screening tests is that many people leading their daily life don't want to think about the possibility of colon or rectal cancer, and they may believe that because they feel well, there's absolutely no chance that there's anything wrong. But polyps and early tumors are often not symptomatic. That is the whole reason that screening is instituted in people without symptoms. If we find a tumor before it has caused symptoms, it's much more treatable, so the cure rate is much higher.
The idea is that you want to go in at least 10 years before a problem is going to occur. So typically, the peak years for colon cancer to develop are in the 60s, and that's the reason we start looking at 50. Most cancers don't arise out of the blue. They usually arise from polyps that have been growing for a decade or more. And the idea is if you go in at the age of 50, the procedure is going to pick up at most small polyps that are easy to get out. Small polyps are also associated with low complication rates as you remove them.
So if you're 50 years of age or older, you should have your colon evaluated with the colonoscopy. And there's just no reason in the world to put it off. It prevents colorectal cancer. Everybody talks about how horrible it is, and they put it off, and they put it off, and they don't do it. The fact of the matter is, there is nothing wrong with the colonoscopy. You are not aware when it occurs. When you go to your colonoscopy, they give you a little sedation, and the next thing you know, you're waking up saying, are we done? So the part that people say, well, the unpleasant part is the bowel prep. The bowel prep is only unpleasant if you decide to take the bowel prep and then try to go to a movie. You should take the bowel prep and stay near a toilet, and then when you do that, it cleans you out and it is no big deal.
Typically, if you find the colon's normal, a patient does not need to come back for repeat colonoscopy for 10 years. Now, that's a long period of time. So it's really important the endoscopist gets to see every bit of your colon. And that's where it's very, very important to have a very clean colon at the time of your procedure. So one of the things we do a lot of is we get referred a lot of patients who failed colonoscopy in the outset for various reasons. And so we use a multitude of very specialized techniques out here. And we also have some very special scopes, one in particular that has a very short turn radius, so it can turn on a dime. And that scope really allows us to get through very complex fixed colons with ease. And so we succeed in almost every case that has failed on the outside. This is a world-class unit, really, and all of our people, our physicians and nurses, our technicians, are really dedicated to providing patients with the best possible safety, comfort, and experience overall.
In the older population, we're seeing colorectal cancer incidence go down. We think that's in large part due to screening.
The hope of public health efforts to increase the rate of screening, as well as efforts to improve the technology that we have available for screening, is that one day colon and rectal cancer could be a rare disease.